enthrone Jesus in this place. Amen. We enthrone Jesus in this place. Jesus, we enthrone.
You up in our praise.
Let's praise Him. Let's worship Him. Let's honor Him. Oh, we magnify You, Jesus. We magnify You, Jesus. You alone are worthy. You alone are worthy, God. Your name, we lift Your name.
Lord, I lift Your name on high. Lord, I love to sing Your praises. I'm so glad You're in my life. I'm so glad You came to save us. You came from heaven to earth.
Just the people, You came from heaven. Come on, sing it out, church.
You came from heaven to earth to show the way from the earth to the cross. My debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift Your name on high.
You came from heaven.
You came from heaven. To show the way from the earth to the cross, my debt to pay from the cross to the grave, from the grave to the sky. Lord, I lift Your name on high. Lord, I lift Your name on high. Lord, I lift Your name.
Our banner.
Yeah.
Jesus, the name above all names, Jesus. We magnify and glorify you, Lord. You are worthy. Oh, yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Move in our midst tonight.
Thank you for your grace.
Is our God. He is truly to be exalted. Let's remain standing for the scripture reading, which is taken from the book of Mark, chapter 14, verses 22 to 26. القراءة مأخوذة من إنجيل مرقس أصحاح 14 عدد 22 ل 26. And as they were eating, Jesus took bread, blessed and broke it, and gave it to them and said, "Take, eat, this is my body." Then he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, and they all drank from it. And he said to them, "This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for many. Assuredly, I say to you, I will no longer drink of the fruit of the vine until the day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." And when they had sung a hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Blessed be the word of the Lord.
Disobeyed the Father. We were then held captive by our sin. The law of God demanded a sacrifice, restoring to himself his own again. So the Lamb, his only Son, was freely offered. Atonement for our sins forever made. He, innocent and holy, still God and God only, would ransom and redeem us back again.
the cross they carried him, with all our guilt and all our sin. The Lamb of God was slain for our transgressions. And on the cross, those nail-pierced hands reach up to God and down to men. And just as if I'd never sinned, he took me in his arms, embracing me, he willingly forgave. For mercy, grace, and love that knows no bounds, though guilty and condemned,
confession together. Have mercy upon us, O God, according to thy tender mercies. Blot out our transgressions. Wash us thoroughly from our iniquities and cleanse us from our sin. Create in us a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within us.
Restore unto us the joy of salvation, and uphold us with thy free spirit.
Amen.
This is our confession. We believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit.
Coming again. This is
will always be there. I had the blessed opportunity to visit the British Museum a few months ago. There was an exhibit with many ancient manuscripts. One of the oldest Bibles, if not the oldest intact Bible in the world, is there. In addition to that, there was a manuscript called Greek Papyrus number 6. This was dated to AD 500. This is the earliest copy, the earliest known copy of the Apostles' Creed. It is amazing to think that for more than 1,500 years, we as Christians, we as followers of Christ, we as partakers in his body and his blood, and believers in his resurrection, have been saying this statement of belief. Let us all say the Apostles' Creed together. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died and buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits on the right hand of God, the Father Almighty. From there he shall come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the holy universal church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Let us pray the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Please be seated. I'd like to call upon the ushers to take the tithes and
sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for
His body the bread, His blood the wine, broken and poured out, all for love. The whole earth trembled and the veil was torn. Love so amazing. You're the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all. All our hope is in you.
To the offering basket. Father in heaven, we thank you for bringing us all to your house safely. We are so blessed by your presence here with us today. Dear Lord, we thank you for another chance for us to meet together and to worship you. Heavenly Father, we come to your throne with humble hearts. We thank you for the countless blessing that you bestow upon us all daily. We experience your blessing, and it is always given to us freely and with ultimate love. O Lord, we thank you for your steadfast love and mercy on us. No one ever gives a present to someone with reluctance. Therefore, we too do not want to give to you with reluctance, as what we are giving you actually belongs to you, Lord. Help us always to be cheerful givers. Lord, may we always give with gladness and sincerity. May we not give to become richer, but may we give simply because we love you, Lord. We believe that every word in the Bible is God-breathed, and its promises are A and Amen. And you promise that you will bless us when we are obedient to your word. And so, Lord, we gladly give to you without hesitation. May we never withhold what is yours. Thank you for the countless ways in which you have blessed us in the past, are doing at present, and will be doing in the future. Accept and bless these offerings which your people have brought, Father, we pray. Bless these cheerful givers, Lord. Father, you loved us so much that you gave your only begotten Son to be offered as a supreme sacrifice on the cross. We thank you, Jesus, for dying on the cross in our stead and thereby redeeming us. We thank you for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Help us to reciprocate that love. May we love you enough to give back to you cheerfully and not under compulsion. Remind us always that we can do nothing without you. Give us wisdom and how to use this money that has been collected. Help us to be good stewards of the resources that you have made available to us in order to advance your kingdom here on earth. We love you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' mighty and matchless name we pray. And all God's people say,
Amen. Come on, let's all arise. Let's sing that the doxology, and then again the Arabic worship team is going to lead us in worship. Praise God from whom all blessings flow.
في الوقت اللي احنا فيه واحنا بنفتكر الصليب ان احنا نتجمع من كنائس مختلفه.
It's a great privilege for us during this time as we remember the cross to be gathered from different congregations together.
احنا فرحانين ككنيسه عربيه في الكويت ان احنا نكون موجودين وسطيكم النهارده عشان نسبح الرب بالكلمات البسيطه اللي ربنا هيديها لنا.
We are so blessed as the Arabic congregation to be among you and that we can praise the Lord with the words that he's going to give us today.
واحنا بنحاول نحط ربنا اختار الترانيم كنا بنحاول نشوف الحاجات اللي هي شبه مترجمه عشان تقدروا ترنموا معانا باي لغه موجوده وسطينا.
And as we were choosing the songs we were trying to choose songs that are in both English and Arabic so that we can all sing along.
امين.
Amen.
خلينا نقف مع بعض واحنا بنعبد
together.
Soon. ونفتخر بشخصك مجدا لربك هللويا وصلنا نرفع اسمك ونعلي مجدك ونفتخر بشخصك وصلنا في الأعالي هللويا
This last week, as many of you will know, we've been blessed in the English language congregation, the TLC.
في الأسبوع الماضي الكثير مننا ما نعرفش إن إحنا اتباركنا ك Lighthouse Church.
To have some good friends visit with us from Canada.
إن يكون لنا صديق رائع جاي يزورنا من كندا.
Canada, Africa, most places I think.
من كندا ومن أفريقيا ومن أماكن عديدة أخرى.
We've already been blessed. In our services.
ربنا باركنا جدا في الخدمات اللي قام بيها.
Pastor Gerald has brought the word of God powerfully to us.
Pastor Gerald قدم لينا كلمة الله بقوة.
And his wife Pat too.
وأيضا زوجته Pat.
And we are looking forward to being blessed once more, Pastor Gerald.
وإحنا منتظرين إن الرب يباركنا كمان الليلة مرة كمان.
And we would like to call him forward and pray for him that the Holy Spirit will be on him powerfully tonight.
احنا ندعو عشان يتقدم لقدام ونصلي عشان قوة الروح القدس تكون عليه.
Can we pray for you? Heavenly Father, thank you for this man.
أبانا السماوي نشكرك لأجل هذا الرجل.
Thank you for his preparation tonight, Lord.
أشكرك لأجل استعداده الليلة يا رب.
We want to hear from you.
نريد أن نسمع منك.
Want to hear your spirit speak to our spirits.
نريد أن نسمع أن روحك القدوس بيتكلم إلينا.
So take all his preparation.
خذ رب كل استعداده.
And transform it, Father.
وحوله يا رب.
Make it powerful and strong.
اجعله بقوة.
Let us hear from you tonight.
دعنا نسمع منك يا رب.
Anoint his lips.
يا رب امسح شفتيه.
And bring words for our hearts from yours.
اعطي رب كلمتك تأتي إلى قلوبنا.
In Jesus' name we pray.
في اسم يسوع.
Amen.
Amen.
Good evening. It is so good to be with you here today.
مساء الخير. سعيد أن أكون وياكم الليلة في هذا المكان.
And just the time of singing, it's excellent.
ووقت العبادة كان وقت رائع جدا.
Foretaste of heaven.
ومذاق خاص جدا من السماء.
Thank you, Mark, for the introduction, and we are blessed, my wife and I, to be here with you.
بشكر سيس مارك لأجل تقديمه وإحنا سعداء أنا ومراتي نكون موجودين هنا.
You've been very kind to us in these last few days and let us expect the blessing of God tonight.
كانوا أيام بركة بالنسبة لنا الأيام اللي فاتت وخلينا نتوقع مع بعض بركة الرب الليلة.
Tonight we are here to celebrate a time that is central to the Christian faith.
الليلة احنا جايين بنحتفل معا بوقت خاص جدا ومركزي في الإيمان المسيحي.
Maybe you've celebrated this service hundreds of times in various forms.
يمكن انت حضرت هذه النوع من الخدمة مرات عديدة في أشكال مختلفة.
As some churches celebrate every week the bread and the cup and some maybe once a month, maybe some others once a year.
في بعض الكنائس بتمارس هذا الفرض اللي هو كسر الخبز مرة كل أسبوع أو مرة كل شهر وبعض الكنائس الثانية يمكن مرة كل سنة.
But a couple thousand years ago, something very dramatic happened this night.
لكن من 2000 سنة مضوا شيء خاص جدا حدث في مثل هذه الليلة.
If you have your Bibles, please turn with me to 1 Corinthians chapter 11.
لو معك كتابك المقدس من فضلك افتح معايا كورنثوس الأولى أصحاح 11.
There's something that some 30 years after the death of Jesus that the Apostle Paul wrote, and we've been reading that now for 2,000 years.
حاجة حصلت بعد موت المسيح ب 30 سنة كتب عنها الرسول بولس واحنا بعد 2000 سنة ما زلنا بنحتفظ بهذا الأمر.
In 1 Corinthians chapter 11 verses 23 to 26.
في كورنثوس الأولى أصحاح 11 من عدد 23 إلى عدد 26.
Paul writes this.
كتب بولس هذه الكلمات.
For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night he was betrayed, he took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me."
لأنني تسلمت من الرب ما سلمتكم أيضا إن الرب يسوع في الليلة التي أسلم فيها أخذ خبزا وشكر فكسر وقال خذوا كلوا هذا هو جسدي المكسور لأجلكم اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
In the same way, verse 25, after supper he took the cup saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me."
عدد 25 أيضا كذلك الكأس أيضا بعدما تعشوا قائلا هذه الكأس هي العهد الجديد بدمي اصنعوا هذا كلما شربتم لذكري.
And 26, for whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup, you proclaim the Lord's death until he comes.
في عدد 26 فأنكم كلما أكلتم هذا الخبز وشربتم هذه الكأس تخبرون بموت الرب إلى أن يجي.
Let's pray. Father, we commit this evening to you.
أبانا نحن نضع هذه الأمسية بين يديك.
Thank you, you sent your son Jesus for us.
نشكرك لأنك أرسلت ابنك يسوع لأجلنا.
Thank you for the death on the cross.
نشكرك لأجل موته على الصليب.
And we thank you for the resurrection.
نشكرك أيضا لأجل القيامة.
Let us hear what your spirit is saying tonight to the church.
نعم نريد أن نسمع ما يقول روحك للكنيسة الليلة.
In Jesus' name, amen.
في اسم يسوع, آمين.
It is very interesting that 2,000 years later, this evening, when Jesus celebrated this Passover, it is introduced on the night he was betrayed.
الغريب أنه بعد 2000 سنة من هذه الحادثة اللي فيها يسوع احتفل بالفصح في ذات الليلة هو أسلم.
That doesn't sound very positive.
ده ما بيجيبش حاجة إيجابية قوي.
On the night he was betrayed.
إنه في الليلة التي أسلم فيها.
We've been saying that for 2,000 years as a church.
إحنا بقالنا بنقول كده 2000 سنة ككنيسة.
If you read just a few days prior to that, Jesus was gaining in popularity.
لو قبل ما تقرأ قبل هذه الحادثة بأيام رب يسوع شعبيته كانت بتزداد جدا.
Miracles were happening.
المعجزات كانت بتحصل في كل مكان.
People were talking of Jesus.
كل الناس كانت بتحكي عن يسوع.
And they would say, "Is this the Messiah?"
وكانوا بيقولوا هذا هو المسيح.
In fact, by this time, it was already out that he is the Messiah.
في هذا الوقت كان أغلب الناس بتظن إنه فعلاً هو ذا المسيح.
And this is emphasized in Palm Sunday, which we celebrated just last week.
وده كان ظاهر جداً وواضح في أحد السعف اللي كنا بنحتفل به الحد الماضي.
As people would take the palms and put them down and say, "Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord."
الناس كانت بتاخد سعف النخيل وتضعه أمامه وتقول مبارك الآتي باسم الرب.
And it was a privilege to see it this week here on this campus as the children marched around with the palms and reenacted that.
وكان شيء رائع ان نشوف ده هنا في الكنيسه خلال هذا الاسبوع والاطفال بيحملوا السعف وهم بيقولوا مبارك اسم الرب.
And in the time they were praising Jesus, the man of Galilee.
وفي هذا الوقت كانوا بيمدحوا في يسوع الرجل الاتي من الجليل.
This prophet.
هذا النبي.
This miracle worker.
هذا صانع المعجزات.
This man who could open the eyes of the blind.
الرجل الذي يستطيع أن يفتح عيون العمى.
And cause the lame to walk.
الذي يعطي الأعرج أن يمشي.
The crowds were growing.
There was
an anticipation.
كان هناك توقع.
The Messiah is coming.
أن المسيح آتي.
And this night.
وفي هذه الليلة.
When he's together with his disciples.
وكان بيجتمع معهم بتلاميذه.
We would think should be this great celebration.
كنا نظن إنه يكون في احتفال عظيم.
Let's call it a supper of celebration.
ونقول إنه ده عشاء احتفال.
But what happens? We know it as a dinner of denial.
لكن ما نعرفه هو إنه كان عشاء للإنكار.
On the night of his betrayal.
في الليلة التي أسلم فيها.
Well, it's easy to point fingers at Judas.
وإحنا بنشاور بصوابعنا على يهوذا.
We can say he's the culprit.
ونقول إنه هو ده اللي تسبب في كل الألم.
He's the betrayer.
هو الشخص الخائن.
He's the one who let Jesus down.
هذا هو اللي أسقط يسوع.
But it wasn't just him.
لكن ما كانش هو لوحده.
Jesus said to Peter, before this evening is over and the rooster crows, you are going to deny me three times.
رب يسوع ايضا قال لبطرس قبل ما يصيح الديك الليلة انت تنكرني ثلاث مرات.
When Judas did betray him.
لما يهوذا انكر رب يسوع.
And when Jesus was brought in front of the high priests.
ولما يسوع احضر امام رئيس الكهنة.
The other disciples gone.
كل التلاميذ الاخرين مضوا.
Judas wasn't the only one who deserted Jesus.
يهوذا هو الوحيد اللي كان هناك.
So 2000 years later,
بعد 2000 سنة,
we look at this night.
بننظر لهذه الليلة.
And that's why Paul said already 30 years later on the night he was betrayed.
وعشان كده بولس بيقول بعد 30 سنة في الليلة التي أسلم فيها.
I want to call this talk here tonight, remember me.
اللي انا عايز احط لي عنوان الليلة هنا هو اذكروني.
Two simple words.
كلمتين صغيرين خالص.
Remember me.
اذكروني.
Because this was the heart of Jesus.
لأنه ده كان قلب يسوع.
On the night he was betrayed.
في الليلة التي أسلم فيها.
He said, "Remember me."
قال تذكروني.
And dear saints, that's why we're here tonight.
وأعتقد إنه ده نفس السبب اللي إحنا موجودين عشانه هنا الليلة.
Because we're remembering Jesus.
لأن إحنا بنتذكر يسوع.
There's nothing else that unites us.
ما فيش أي شيء يجمعنا مع بعض.
The blood of Jesus Christ.
غير دم يسوع المسيح.
And what He has done for us.
وما صنعه لأجلنا.
Do this in remembrance of me.
اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
The word remembrance
كلمة ذكرى
has a sliding value, an adjustable value.
ليها قيمة خاصة جدا.
It's like our sound men have in the back the sliding buttons that go up and down to control the volume.
زي ما اللي قاعد على ماكينة الصوت ورا عنده صوت بيعلي ويوطي بيه.
And they learn to compensate when it goes up and when it goes down.
وبيتعلم ازاي انه يظبط الصوت على حد صوته اعلى وحد صوته اكتر انخفاضا.
You know that our memory works something like that.
في ذاكرتنا امور بتمشي زي كده.
Perhaps sometimes the older we get it, we don't have control.
عادة لما بنتقدم في السن ما عندناش يعني تحكم
but
بزيادة.
On an average, we talk about this thing, selective memory.
لكن في المتوسط عندنا يعني اختيار للذاكرة.
My wife and I are blessed with three beautiful grandchildren.
أنا وزوجتي ربنا باركنا بثلاث أحفاد.
And a number of months ago, we were able to spend some time with them, and it was a joy and a privilege.
ومن شهور ماضت كان لنا امتياز نقضي معهم بعض الوقت.
But as I watch them,
وأنا بلاحظهم,
brings back memories.
ده جاب لي كتير من الذكريات.
Even to when I was a child.
لما كنت طفل.
And we have already at early childhood we exercise how to slide our value of remembrance.
وإحنا صغيرين كنا بنتعلم إزاي إن إحنا نضع ونختار ذكرياتنا.
So suppose the father's at work and the mother's at home with the children and the child misbehaves.
ونفترض إنه الأب في العمل والأم مع الأولاد في البيت والولد يعني شقي بيقل أدبه.
And then the mother corrects the child.
والأم بتحاول إنها تصحح الولد.
And says, "Just wait until Daddy comes home."
وتقول استنى بس لما يجي أبوك.
And he'll help you.
وهو هيساعدك يعني.
Poor kid's just sweating.
وطفل بيبقى بيعرق.
So the dad comes home.
ولما يجي بابا يرجع البيت.
And the child has been praying one thing all day.
والطفل ده بيكون بيصلي حاجة واحدة كل اليوم.
God help mama to forget.
يا رب ساعد ماما إنها تنسى.
Let her memory fade.
خلى رب إنه ذاكرتها تمحى بالكامل.
Please God.
يا رب من فضلك.
I'll be good tomorrow.
ويعني أنا هبقى كويس بكرة.
On the other hand.
من الناحية الثانية.
When the child is good.
لما يكون الطفل كويس.
And the mother says, "When Daddy comes home."
وتقول الأم لما بابا يرجع البيت.
He's going to take you out for ice cream.
هياخدك علشان يجيب لك ice cream.
Guess what the child's prayer is.
دي صلاة الطفل هو بيقول.
God help mama to remember.
يا رب ساعد ماما إنها تفتكر.
Give her a sharp memory.
اديها رب ذاكرة حادة.
And all day long the child is praying for a good memory.
وكل اليوم هو بيصلي عشان الذاكرة الحادة.
That's children.
ده الأطفال.
But as adults,
لكن احنا ككبار,
we've also learned to realize something about remembrance.
احنا بنتعلم شيء عن التذكر.
We know the feeling.
عارفين المشاعر.
If we talk with someone,
لما نتكلم مع حد,
and we think we had a very good conversation,
ونظن ان احنا كان عندنا محادثة طيبة جدا,
and you meet them some months later,
ونقابله بعد الشهور,
and they say, I don't recall our meeting.
وأقول الحقيقة مش فاكر إن إحنا تقابلنا.
Hurts.
حاجة بتوجع قلبك.
On the flip side, on the other side.
من الناحية التانية.
We talk with someone.
تكلم مع حد.
And maybe it's 2-3 years later.
وبعد يمكن سنتين ثلاثة.
And the minute we see them.
أول ما تشوفه.
Say, I remember you.
أنا فكرك.
Back then and back then.
في الوقت الفلاني ومكان الفلاني.
You see, memory is also linked with emotions.
والذاكرة لها علاقة بالعواطف والمشاعر.
And as we also know that memory is linked with respect.
وأيضا الذكريات لها علاقة بالاحترام والقيمة.
And so we can control the slide of remembrance.
وإحنا نستطيع إن إحنا نتحكم في مجرى هذه الذكريات.
And Jesus did something.
والرب يسوع عمل شيء.
On the night he was betrayed.
في الليلة التي أسلم فيها.
He took the bread.
أخذ خبزا.
And he took the cup.
وأخذ الكأس.
And he broke the bread.
كسر الخبز.
And he said, "Remember me."
وقال اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
He took the cup.
أخذ الكأس.
And he said, "Remember me."
وقال تذكروني.
We have some choices about the memory.
لنا بعض الاختيارات بما يختص بالذاكرة.
So. In this evening,
في هذه الليلة,
as we are remembering Jesus,
ونحن نتذكر يسوع,
we have to ask ourselves, what is it that we are remembering?
لابد ان احنا نسأل السؤال, هو ايه بالضبط اللي احنا بنذكره?
And I want to take a few minutes and just look at three people in the Bible.
وعايز اخد وقت ابص على ثلاث اشخاص في كلمة الله.
Who had this on their hearts.
كان عندهم هذا الامر جوه قلوبهم.
Who said to somebody else, "Remember me"?
اللي قالوا لحد تاني افتكرني.
Let's see what we can learn from them.
خلينا نشوف إيه اللي ممكن نتعلمه منهم.
The first person.
أول شخص.
In Genesis chapter 40.
في تكوين أصحاح 40.
14 and 15.
عدد 14 و15.
We read here this story of Joseph, and we all know that Joseph had a very rough background.
بنقرا قصة عن يوسف وكلنا عارفين ان يوسف كان عنده خلفية تاريخية في حياته شقة جدا.
His first few years were very good.
سنينه الاولى كانت كويسة.
But then when his brothers began to despise him, everything seemed to go downhill.
لكن بعد ما ابتدى اخواته ان هم يغزوه ويحتقروه حياته اتقلبت بقت شيء عسير جدا.
He's blessed.
كان مبارك.
And then he's put down.
ولكنه أخفض أو انحط.
He's raised up.
أقيم وارتفع.
And then he's put down. It's the life of Joseph.
ولكنه انحط مرة تانية.
One of these times.
واحد من المرات دي.
He's sitting in jail.
كان موجود في السجن.
Unjustly punished.
بصورة ظالمة كان بيعاقب.
He's been in there for some years.
كان هناك لمدة سنوات.
And then something happens one day.
ولكن في شيء حدث في يوم من الأيام.
Two men came to him and said, "We had dreams."
اثنين رجال قولوا قالوا له احنا حلمنا أحلام.
And to the one he gives a very positive interpretation.
والواحد منهم أعطى تفسير إيجابي جدا.
But to the other one a very negative one.
وللآخر أعطى له تفسير سلبي جدا.
But the cupbearer.
لكن الخباز.
Was the one.
Sorry, ساقي الملك.
The cupbearer was the one who had an excellent report on his dream.
كان يوسف عنده تقرير إيجابي جدا عن حلمه.
And Joseph said, "In 3 days, you're going to be restored to your job."
وقال له إنه في ثلاث أيام أنت هترجع مرة تاني إلى عملك.
Look what he says.
بص قال له إيه.
Joseph says to him, "He's in prison."
يوسف قال له موجود في السجن.
Unjust.
بصورة ظالمة.
And he says to the cupbearer, "When all goes well with you, remember me and show me kindness. Mention me to Pharaoh and get me out of this prison."
قال له إنما إذا ذكرتني عندك حينما يصير لك خير تصنع لي إحسانا وتذكرني لفرعون وتخرجني من هذا البيت.
Let's put ourselves in Joseph's position.
خلينا نحط نفسنا مكان يوسف.
I don't know what kind of legal system they had back then.
أنا مش عارف النظام اللي كان موجود عندهم في الوقت ده.
And he was a foreigner.
وكان شخص غريب.
He was brought in as a slave.
كان بيعامل كعبد.
And probably even if they did have a good legal system, I can guarantee you he probably didn't have access to it.
حتى لو كان عندهم قضاء عادل أنا أظن إنه ما كانش عنده سكة يوصل لهذا القضاء العادل.
And so here comes this ray of hope.
وقالوا أمل ورجاء في إيديه.
The man who is the closest to the Pharaoh, who takes his cup and makes sure that it's not poisoned.
الشخص القريب جدا من فرعون اللي بياخد كأسه وبيتأكد أنه هذا الكأس غير مسموم.
He is restored to his job.
رجع مرة تاني وترد ليه عمله.
I am sure Joseph knew him quite well.
أنا متأكد إن يوسف عرف هذا الرجل معرفة شخصية قريبة جدا.
And the cupbearer had seen how Joseph had was put in charge of the prison and how he was doing things very well. He's a good man.
وساقي الفرعون كان شايف قد ايه يوسف اوكل اليه انه يكون عنده اداره في السجن وانه بيصنع امور عظيمه. كان رجل طيب كويس.
And now the cupbearer is going to the king.
وبيرجع مره ثاني ساقي الملك الى فرعون.
And all that the Pharaoh would have to say is one word, and Joseph would be out of jail.
كل ما يقوله فرعون هو كلمة واحدة بس ويوسف يطلع من السجن.
He can bypass the whole legal system.
كان يعدي فوق كل النظم القضائية.
That's connections.
ده الفن الاتصال.
His opportunity was there.
الفرصة كانت موجودة هناك.
And he cries out.
وكان بيتأمل في ده.
Remember. Me.
اذكرني.
The guy gets his job back.
ساقي فرعون رجع له شغله مرة تاني.
And we know what happens.
وعارفين اللي حصل.
Look at verse 23.
خلينا نبص على عدد 23.
Very sad. The chief cupbearer, however, did not remember Joseph. He forgot him.
ولكن لم يذكر رئيس السقاة يوسف بل نسيه.
I wonder how many mornings Joseph got up thinking today's the day that the cupbearer is going to tell the king.
ما اعرفش كم مره يوسف صحي الصبح وهو بيقول النهارده ساقي فرعون اكيد هيفتكرني.
And if he puts in the good word I'll be out of here.
ولو قدمها بصوره كويسه انا هطلع من هنا.
Day after day after day.
يوم بعد يوم بعد يوم.
Nothing.
ولا حاجه حصلت.
You know the story.
كلنا عارفين القصه.
One day he did remember.
يوم من الايام هذا الرجل تذكر.
And it changed the life of Joseph.
وغير حياة يوسف بالكامل.
There's a second man in the Bible.
واحد ثاني في كلمة الله.
Please turn to Luke chapter 23.
في لوقا اصحاح 23.
Jesus was condemned as a criminal.
رب يسوع أدين كمجرم.
It's not just that he was condemned to die anyhow.
لم يدان علشان يموت أي موتة.
That you know, well, he's not a bad guy, but he's got a lot of enemies. No, he was legally condemned as a criminal.
لكن هو صنف إنه زي مجرم خطر.
And he went to the cross with criminals on each side of him.
وراح إلى الصليب مع عدد اثنين من المجرمين عن يمين وعن يسار.
The cross was their form of capital punishment.
الصليب كان أداة للإعدام في ذلك الوقت.
The accusations against Jesus were at such a level that he was guilty of being a threat to the government.
والتهمة اللي كانت ضد يسوع أنه تهديد حقيقي للحكومة عشان كده هو يعني يهدد نظام الحكم زي ما احنا بنقول.
Wrongly accused, but nevertheless he hung on the cross as a criminal.
ولكنه أخذ هذا الذنب كمجرم على الصليب.
So while he's up there on the cross, still alive.
وهو على الصليب.
Got two troublemakers on each side. Some translations call them thieves. Others call them rebellious people or.
كان في اثنين بيدعوهم إنهم مجرمين أو صانعي أو يثيروا مشاكل.
Both of them were guilty.
لكن هم الاثنين كانوا مذنبين.
They were condemned guilty.
كان محكوم عليهم لأنهم مذنبين.
And they were guilty.
وكانوا فعلا مذنبين.
The one man said,
واحد منهم قال,
turns to Jesus and says, if you're this great hero, why don't you get yourself out of here and get us out of here as well?
قال له لو كنت انت هذا البطل العظيم اللي الناس بتحكي عنه ما تخلص نفسك وايانا.
I'm sure he heard stories.
انا اعتقد انه سمع قصص كثير.
He knew who Jesus was.
كان عارف مين هو يسوع.
Maybe he even heard of the dead being coming back to life.
يمكن سمع عن الموتى اللي قامهم يسوع.
And he's thinking, man, I'm about to die myself.
ويقول يا عم انا عايز اموت عن نفسي.
Here's my connection.
وده اللي يقدر يقومني.
Jesus, get us out of here.
يا عم طلعنا قومنا من هنا.
Jesus doesn't even respond to him.
رب يسوع حتى لم يستجيب إليه.
The other man,
شخص الآخر,
recognizes something.
أدرك شيء.
He realizes he's guilty.
أدرك إنه هو مذنب.
Because he's done wrong.
لأنه فعل شيء خطأ.
But he looks at Jesus with a different set of eyes.
ويشاف يسوع بنظرة مختلفة.
He sees him as his eternal salvation.
شافه كخلاصه الأبدي.
And we read in Luke chapter 23 verse 42. He turns to Jesus and he says, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
قال ليسوع اذكرني يا رب متى جئت في ملكوتك.
Jesus turns to him.
رب يسوع التفت إليه.
And he says, today you will be with me in paradise.
قال اليوم تكون معي في الفردوس.
Both of these men were probably Jewish.
أغلب الظن أن الاثنين المجرمين كانوا يهود.
Both of them probably understood the annual festivals in which the animals were sacrificed.
وأعتقد هما الاثنين كانوا فاهمين الاحتفال السنوي اللي فيه بيذبح الحمل أو الخروف.
Probably understood the weekly sacrifices that were given.
وكانوا يمكن فاهمين أيضا الذبيحة الأسبوعية اللي بتقدم كفارة للخطية.
And how when the animals were sacrificed, their blood would be sprinkled on the altar.
وكانوا بيعرفوا إنه عندما يذبح هذا الذبيح أو الخروف إنه دمه بيرش على المذبح.
And their sins would be covered over.
وإنه خطاياهم بتغطى أو بتغفر.
Put ourselves in their position.
خلينا نحط نفسنا في مكانهم.
We're guilty.
احنا مذنبين.
Our sins have caught up to us.
وخطايانا احنا ممسوكين بيها.
The sins of the past.
خطايا ماضينا.
There may have been previous confessions, maybe previous sacrifices, maybe they went to a religious leader and paid good money to get their sins covered over.
يمكن كان ليهم خطايا في الماضي وراحوا لكهنة وقدموا ذبايح دفعوا فلوس علشان تغتفر خطاياهم.
But their lifestyle didn't change.
لكن اسلوب حياتهم لم يتغير.
And their sins caught up with them, and now they're on the cross.
وخطاياهم لحقت بهم عشان كده الآن هم على الصليب.
He sees Jesus now in a different light.
هو شايف يسوع في ضوء ونور مختلف.
Now, folks, you and I, we have the New Testament.
أحبائي أنا وأنتوا إحنا عندنا العهد الجديد.
Take a look at Hebrews chapter 11
خلينا
and verse 3.
لما ننظر إلى عبرانيين أصحاح 11 وعدد 3.
The whole book of Hebrews is about a better sacrifice.
وكل سفر العبرانيين عن ذبيحة أفضل.
Not a sacrifice that covers over.
مش ذبيحة بتغطي.
But a sacrifice that takes away the sins.
لكن ذبيحة بتمحو الخطايا.
Hebrews 11:3 says, but in those sacrifices there is a remembrance again made of sins every year.
في عبرانيين 10:3 بتقول كلمة الله ولكن فيها كل سنة ذكر خطايا.
This word
Hebrews 10, not 11.
These words remembrance is only 4 times in the New Testament, that specific word.
الكلمة ذكر أو تذكر مذكورة 4 مرات في العهد الجديد.
We've read it in Luke 23.
قريناها في لوقا 23.
Jesus says, do this in remembrance of me.
يسوع قال اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
And twice in 1 Corinthians.
ومرتين في كورنثوس الأولى.
And this is the 4th time.
ودي المرة الرابعة.
When the people would come to the priest
لما يأتي الناس إلى الكاهن
and have the animal sacrificed for their sins
وعندهم دم الحيوان لأجل خطاياهم
the focus was on the sin
التركيز كان على الخطية
the very act of the sacrifice reminded them of their sins
العمل الذبيحة وتقديمها في حد ذاته بيذكر الناس بخطاياهم
This man on the cross
لكن هذا الرجل اللي على الصليب
was hanging in a state of time in which things were about to change
كان موجود على الصليب في وقت اللي فيه كل الأمور في حياته هتتغير
In proximity he was probably the closest ever to the most exciting day and event in the course of history.
والحاجة الغريبة إنه هو كان أقرب ما يكون في حياته للحظة اللي ممكن فيها حياته تتغير.
In his desperation, he turns to Jesus and says, "Remember me."
في احتياجه الشديد التفت ليسوع وقال اذكرني.
When we ask Jesus something,
لما نسأل الرب يسوع على شيء,
he has our best interest at heart.
وعنده شيء كويس جوا القلب.
And sometimes we really, really don't know how to ask. And what this man was about to experience was something that you and I have been reading about as believers for 2,000 years.
As Christians.
Jesus said, I'll do more than remember you.
قال أنا هعمل حاجة أكتر من أنني أتذكرك.
I will take your sins.
أنا هاخد خطاياك.
I have your sins.
أنا حربي خطاياك عليا.
I am carrying your sins.
أنا هحمل خطاياك.
And I'm now dying on your behalf.
وأنا الآن بموت عوضا عنك.
This is the Jesus we serve.
هذا هو يسوع الذي نخدمه.
He doesn't just cover our sins.
مش بس بيغطي خطايانا.
He takes away our sins.
ولكنه يأخذها بالكامل.
Our sins, your sins and my sins.
خطاياي وخطاياك.
Were there in him, on him, on the cross.
كانت عليه على الصليب.
And he died for you and for me.
ومات من أجلي ومن أجلك.
As many times we say that our sins killed him.
مرة كثيرة بنقول إنه خطايانا قتلته.
And the only reason Jesus was on the cross is because the sin of mankind.
السبب الوحيد اللي جعل يسوع يكون على الصليب بسبب خطايا الإنسانية.
The sins of the past.
أخذ خطايا الماضي.
The sins of the present.
خطايا الحاضر.
And the sins of the future.
وخطايا المستقبل أيضا.
On him to the cross.
جعلت عليه على الصليب.
For you and for me.
لك ولأجلي.
And this man, this criminal,
وهذا المجرم
turns to Jesus and says, "Remember me."
التفت ليسوع وقال له تذكرني.
And what he didn't know.
واللي ما كانش يعرفه.
Was that was a change of history in a few hours.
إنه كان ده تغيير في تاريخه في ساعات قليلة.
The very sins of that criminal.
إنه هذه الدماء بتاعت هذا المجرم.
Jesus took.
يسوع أخذها.
And as we read in the Apostles' Creed, went to hell
for them. زي ما قرينا في إيمان الرسل إن رب يسوع ذهب إلى الهوية.
I thank God for Sunday.
أشكر الله لأجل الأحد.
Because Sunday is a day of life.
لأنه يوم الأحد يوم القيامة يعني أتى لنا بالحياة.
Because not only did Jesus take our sins.
لا مش يسوع بس مش أخذ خطايانا.
And people thought, oh, we finally killed Jesus.
ونقول لقينا اللي قتل يسوع.
But Jesus killed the power of sin.
ولكن الرب يسوع قتل شوكة وقوة الخطية.
He took away the sting of death.
أخذ إنه شوكة الموت.
Death can't take any mastery over us anymore. Jesus did that for us.
الرب يسوع صنع ده لنا.
He has given us hope.
أعطانا رجاء.
And he's given us life.
يعطينا حياة.
And that man on the cross.
وهذا الرجل على الصليب.
Was the first to find out about it.
كان أول واحد يجد هذا المعنى.
When I get to heaven.
عندما أذهب للسماء.
I want to meet him.
أنا عايز أقابل الرجل ده.
See if he had any idea of what he said on that cross.
لو كان يعلم أي فكرة عن إيه اللي قاله على الصليب.
When he turned to Jesus and said, "Remember me."
لما التفت ليسوع وقال اذكرني.
And Jesus did remember him.
وتذكره الرب يسوع.
And he did see him that day in paradise.
وشافه في هذا اليوم في الفردوس.
The beautiful part about this.
الجزء الجميل في كل ده.
Is this criminal was hoping.
إنه هذا المجرم كان لدي أمل.
I can guarantee you he's been told all kinds of promises before.
أنا يعني أقدر أجزم لك إنه تلقى كل أنواع الوعود قبل كده.
And because he was a criminal,
وبسبب إنه كان مجرم,
he has probably also told many stories.
وأيضا يعني قال قصص كتيرة اخترعها.
Given many promises and never kept them.
وأعطى برضو مواعيد كتيرة.
And so when he turned to Jesus and said, "Remember me."
ولما التفت إلى يسوع وقال اذكرني.
It was his last glimmer of hope on this life. That was it.
كانت آخر أمنية ورجاء في حياته.
He was already on the cross.
كان خلاص هو على الموت على الصليب.
He was already hanging there.
كان معلق هناك.
The soldiers were not going to take him down.
الجنود مش هينزلوه من على الصليب.
This was his last chance.
ده كان آخر فرصة بالنسبة له.
This is his last hope.
آخر أمل بالنسبة له.
If you're here tonight,
لو أنت هنا الليلة,
and you have not yet accepted Jesus Christ as personal
Lord
and Savior, ولم
تقبل يسوع إنه يكون مخلصك الشخصي,
I want to urge you. I want to beg you.
أنا بشجعك اليوم وأطلب منك.
You don't know what tomorrow holds.
أنت ما تعرفش بكرة جاي في إيه.
Not one of us have any guarantee.
ولا واحد مننا ضامن يحصل إيه بكرة.
And if you've not yet accepted Jesus Christ as personal Lord and Savior,
لو ما قبلتش يسوع كمخلص ليك ورب,
your sins are still with you.
خطاياك لسه هتكون معاك.
But they don't have to be.
لكن مش لازم تكون معاك.
Tonight,
الليلة,
you can turn to Jesus.
ممكن تيجي ليسوع.
And he can appropriate the cross for you. Tonight.
إنه يضع الصليب من أجلك أنت أيضا الليلة.
And you can be made new in Christ Jesus.
وإنك تكون شخصية جديدة في المسيح يسوع.
You see, Jesus is not some kind of a celestial angel or celestial being who is a cup bearer in heaven for his Father.
رب يسوع مش هذا الشخص الخرافي اللي بيحمل الكاس لأجل أبوه في السماوات.
He is not like the cupbearer who will forget.
ده مش زي ساقي فرعون اللي نسي.
When we call out to Jesus,
لما ندعو يسوع,
the minute we call to him,
في اللحظة اللي بندعوه,
he enacts.
هو على طول فعال إنه يستجيب.
And our sins can be forgiven.
وخطايانا تغفر بالكامل.
It is immediate.
فورا.
It is forever.
وللأبد.
And Jesus will never ever forget anyone who calls on him.
والرب يسوع لن ينسى اي احد يدعو باسمه.
There's an old song, a hymn that we sang. I remember singing it many times and just coming to it. It's called At Calvary.
في ترنيمة قديمة بتقول في الجلجوثة.
It says, years I spent in vanity and pride, caring not my Lord was crucified, knowing not it was for me he died on Calvary.
بس هو ده.
فهمت؟ Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary.
Amen.
It is. You sing this one in Arabic?
No, I said it all, yeah. No? They got it in the spirit right away.
Hey, praise God.
Don't worry.
Next year we'll hear it in Arabic. Now I've given to Jesus everything. Now I gladly own him as my king. Now my raptured soul can only sing of Calvary. Oh, the love that drew salvation's plan. Oh, the grace that brought it down to man. Oh, the mighty gulf that God did span at Calvary. Mercy there was great and grace was free. Pardon there was multiplied to me. There my burdened soul found liberty at Calvary.
Amen.
It is at Calvary that Jesus meets our need.
It is على الجلجوثة الرب يسوع غفر خطايانا.
It is at Calvary that our sins are rolled away.
في الجلجوثة الرب يسوع خطايانا محيت بالكامل.
And it doesn't matter about our past.
ومش مهم إيه اللي حصل في ماضينا.
When you can have these criminals hanging beside Jesus.
لما تشوف هذا المجرم معلق بجوار الرب يسوع.
And everyone knew that they are guilty.
وكل واحد عارف إنه مجرم.
And he turns to the one and says, "Today you'll be with me in
paradise." يسوع يلتفت إليه ويقول اليوم تكون معي في الفردوس.
We have that same opportunity.
إحنا عندنا نفس الفرصة.
You see, because you and I are destined to be hanging on that cross.
احنا ايضا معينين سابقا لنعلق على الصليب.
And if it weren't for Jesus, we would have to die for our own sins.
ولولا الرب يسوع كان مفروض ان كل واحد مننا يموت لاجل خطاياه.
And for all eternity be separated from God.
وللابديه حنكون منفصلين عن الرب.
But Jesus.
لكن يسوع.
But his love.
ومحبته.
And so Jesus says, whenever you take of my blood,
كلما اخذتم الكاس ودمي,
whenever you take my body,
كلما اكلتم من جسدي,
remember me,
اذكروني.
The third person,
الشخص الثالث,
with this I close,
واللي بيبقى اختم.
You guessed it, who it is.
اعتقد ان انتم يعني خمنتوا هو مين.
Jesus.
يسوع نفسه.
1 Corinthians 11, this is our text.
في النص اللي احنا بنقراه في كورنثوس الاولى اصحاح 11.
Some 30 years later.
30 سنه بعد هذه الحادثه بتاعه خميس العهد.
After the death and resurrection of Jesus.
بعد موت وقيامه الرب يسوع.
Paul writes.
كتب بولس وقال.
For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you.
لاني تسلمت من الرب ما قد سلمتكم اياه.
The Lord Jesus on the night he was betrayed.
انه في الليله التي اسلم فيها يسوع.
He took the bread.
اخذ خبزا.
And when he had given thanks.
وهو يعطي شكرا.
He broke it and said.
كسر وقال.
This is my body which is for you.
هذا هو جسدي المكسور لاجلكم.
Do this in remembrance of me.
اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it."
كذلك الكأس أيضا هذه الكأس هي العهد الجديد بدمي اصنعوا هذا كلما شربتم لذكري.
Do it in remembrance of me.
اصنعوا هذا لذكري.
So here's this word remembrance.
هنا الكلمة تذكر أو ذكرى.
The disciples,
تلاميذ,
were enjoying this supper. Of celebration.
كانوا مستمتعين بهذا العشاء, عشاء الاحتفال.
They had just been humiliated, yes.
كانوا يعني.
Because Jesus came in and he had to wash their feet.
حسوا بالتضاع الشديد لأن الرب يسوع غسل أقدامهم.
They felt embarrassed.
حسوا بالحرج.
Because they were living on this high.
لأنهم كانوا عايشين في حتة فوق.
Jesus had come into Jerusalem as the king.
الرب يسوع أتى إلى أورشليم كملك.
And they were on the inside. They had the connections to the Messiah.
وهم كانوا معاه. كان عندهم الوسطة أن يكونوا قريبين منه.
And they thought, we've got it made in this new establishment.
ولو هو هيعمل حاجة فإحنا عندنا شيء جديد بيؤسس.
And they come into the celebration that night.
وقم إلى العشاء بيحتفلوا في هذه الليلة.
And Jesus predicts the betrayals.
والرب يسوع جه حتى للي هيخونه صنع مع هذا المعروف.
From this high they go to a low.
من المكان المرتفع جدا انخفضوا.
I'm sure that hurt them.
أعتقد إنه هذا الأمر يعني ألمهم بشكل ما.
I'm sure that confused them.
وأيضا سبب ليهم نوع من التشويش.
You say, how is this possible?
إزاي ده يكون ممكن وجائز؟
We're on such a great momentum of going ahead.
احنا يعني في مرحلة فيها حركة للتقدم للأمام نحو المملكة.
And then Jesus tells them a few things.
لكن الرب يسوع قال لهم بعض الأمور.
You won't eat this again until we eat it together in the kingdom of God.
أنا مش هشرب من ده لغاية ما أشربه معكم جديدا في ملكوت الله.
I'm sure they were scratching their heads saying, what's he talking about?
أعتقد هم هرشوا في دماغهم وقالوا هو بيقول إيه بالضبط.
What does he mean?
إيه اللي يعني بهذه الكلمات؟
What is all this betrayal stuff?
إيه قصة إنه حد هيخوني وحد يسلمني؟
But Jesus knew where he's going.
لكن الرب يسوع كان عارف هو بيقول إيه.
And he also saw beyond their betrayal.
وشاف ما هو أبعد من خيانتهم.
And he says to them.
وقال ليهم.
Something that we have now been repeating for 2,000 years.
حاجة بنكررها لمدة 2,000 سنة.
As often as you take this bread and this cup.
كلما أخذتم من هذا الخبز وهذه الكأس.
Our question, we have to ask ourselves.
السؤال اللي إحنا لابد إن إحنا نسأله لأنفسنا.
Tonight.
الليلة.
When we take the cup.
لما نأخذ الكأس والخبز.
How? Are we remembering Jesus?
ازاي بنتذكر رب يسوع؟
Joseph sat in prison hoping every day that the cupbearer would remember him.
بولس كان قابع في السجن وكل يوم عنده امل ان ساقي فرعون هيتذكره.
The criminal who was about to die, he was wondering, What's going to happen? Will Jesus remember me?
المجرم اللي كان على الصليب كان بيسأل نفس السؤال, يا ترى الرب يسوع سيتذكره؟
On the night he was betrayed,
وفي الليلة التي أسلم فيها يسوع,
he turns to you and to me and says, please remember me.
يلتفت إلي وإليك ويقول اذكرني.
Jesus, the King of Kings,
يسوع ملك الملوك,
the Lord of Lords,
رب الأرباب,
the one who sits beside his Father in heaven,
الذي يجلس عن يمين أبيه في السماويات,
asked you and asked me,
يسألك ويسألني,
to remember him.
أن نتذكره.
Who am I?
مين إحنا؟
What does Jesus need from me
that I should remember يسوع him? مني علشان أتذكره.
He wants our hearts.
عايز قلوبنا.
He wants our day-to-day life to remember him.
إن إحنا في حياتنا اليومية نتذكره.
In the things we say.
في الأمور اللي بنتكلم بيها.
In the things we do.
في الأمور اللي بنفعلها.
In the things we think.
في الأمور اللي بنفكر فيها.
Everything about us.
كل شيء جوانا.
We are to remember Jesus.
إن إحنا نذكر في شخص
ربنا. We are to remember his broken body.
إن إحنا نذكر جسده المكسور.
We remember his blood for us.
نذكر دمه لأجلنا.
And Jesus is in the heavens.
ورب يسوع في السماوات.
And he's looking at us.
وينظر إلينا.
And he's still asking.
ولسه بيقول نفس الشيء.
Gerald. Do you remember me?
هل تذكرني؟
Are you daily remembering me?
هل في كل يوم بتتذكرني؟
And he's asking you.
وبيسألك وبيسألك وبيسأل كل واحد فينا.
Me.
اذكرني.
The King of Kings.
ملك الملوك.
Asking us.
بيسألنا إحنا.
A very very simple question.
سؤال بسيط جدا.
Now the responsibility is on us.
المسؤولية وقع علينا دلوقتي.
What are we going to do?
إيه اللي إحنا هنعمله؟
Will we remember him?
هل سنذكره؟
I'm going to ask Brother Ajit to come forward, please.
أنا هسأل أخونا عاجد أن يأتي.
And the brothers and the sisters, the ones who are going to help with the.
وإخواتنا القادة الروحيين اللي جايين يساعدونا في تقديم المائدة.
And as they prepare for this.
وإحنا بنجهز هذه المائدة.
I want us to take a minute and just right where we're sitting. I want us to close our eyes.
وإحنا موجودين في مكاننا. بطلب منكم كلنا إن إحنا نغمض عينينا اللحظة.
And meditate on this just now. Think about this.
فكر في اللي كنا بنقوله.
Hear Jesus speaking to you.
فكر في رب يسوع بيتكلم إليك.
In your spirit, in your heart, hear him asking you the question.
في روحك وفي قلبك بيسأل نفس السؤال.
Are you remembering me?
هل تتذكرني؟
What is our response?
إيه رد فعلنا تجاه كلماته؟
If you're here tonight and you do not yet know Jesus,
لو أنت هنا الليلة ولسه لم تتقابل مع الرب يسوع,
please don't leave this place without
knowing
Jesus.
من فضلك ما تتركش هذا المكان.
Talk to someone.
تكلم إليه.
After the service, there'll be church leaders who are here in the side room.
بعد الكنيسة هيكون في قادة من الكنيسة موجودين بعد الخدمة. لو أنت تكلم مع حد منهم.
We'll talk to you more about how you can know.
هيساعدوك أكتر إزاي تكبر وتنمو في الرب يسوع.
If you're here tonight and you've accepted Jesus as personal Lord and Savior, this celebration now is for you and for me.
لو أنت هنا الليلة وقبلت الرب يسوع رب مخلص, هذا الاحتفال هو من أجلك.
The ushers and servers are passing out the cup and the bread.
الأشرز وهم عادين بيوزعوا علينا الخبز.
They're coming now. Please take one. If you've accepted Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior.
لو قبلت الرب يسوع كمخلص ليك. خد كاس وخبز مع بعض.
We will remember, we will remember the works of your hand. We will stop and give you praise for great is thy We will remember, we will remember, we will remember the works of your hands. We will stop and give you praise for great is thy
God is good.
Our God is good, and He is the faithful one.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the one from whom all blessings flow.
Thank you so much, Pastor Keith, for leading us in that worship. The option and the choice rests with you and with me. Jesus has done His part on the cross. His body was broken. His blood was poured out. And now He's just asking, remember me. You have the wafer in your hand. I'm going to read from 1 Corinthians. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Let us eat together. We're going to ask Pastor Ralph to come up and lead us in prayer. For the bread which we just took and for the cup we're about to take.
Let's pray.
خلينا نصلي.
Dear Father in heaven,
أبانا في السماء,
thank you so much
نشكرك يا رب,
for the amazing love
لأجل المحبة العجيبة,
shown to your son
اللي أظهرتها لينا في
Jesus Christ,
يسوع المسيح.
Thank you for all the details
شكرك لأجل كل التفاصيل,
that you Jesus Christ
أنك أنت يسوع المسيح,
showed us
أظهرتها,
on the night you were betrayed,
في الليلة التي أسلمت فيها.
We praise you,
أننا نباركك,
we glorify you,
نمجدك,
that your body was broken for us,
أن جسدك قد كسر لأجلنا,
and your blood was shed for our sins,
وأن دمك قد سفك لأجل خطايانا,
so that you died and that you rose again,
أنك قد مت وقد قمت ثانية,
we can have life,
والآن يكون لنا حياة,
and an everlasting life,
حياة أبدية.
We have hope for now,
لدينا أمل اليوم,
and for the whole eternity,
ورجاء لكل الأبدية.
We praise you and glorify your name,
نمجدك ونعظم اسمك.
In Jesus' name,
في اسم يسوع.
Amen.
آمين.
In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood."
وكذلك بعد العشاء أخذ كأسا وقال هذه الكأس هي العهد الجديد بدمي.
Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me.
كلما شربت من هذه الكأس اصنع
هذا. For whenever you eat this bread and drink this cup,
كلما أكلتم هذا الخبز وشربتم هذه الكأس,
the Lord's death until he comes.
تخبرون بموت الرب إلى أن يجي.
Let's drink together.
خلينا كلنا نشرب منه معا.
Sing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I was
shall we bow our head for the benediction? خلينا نحني رؤوسنا للصلاة نختم الاجتماع البركة الرسولية. والقادر أن يحفظكم غير عاسرين ويوقفكم أمام مجده بلا عيب في الابتهاج. الإله الحكيم الوحيد مخلصنا له المجد والعظمة والقدرة والسلطان من الآن وإلى كل الدهور. آمين.
Dear brothers and sisters, may the humble example of Jesus Christ, as he washed his disciples' feet, guide and inspire us. May the living sacrifice of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ lead you as you serve one another, looking for the unity that Jesus prayed, that we will all be one. May the love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ bind us together, so that the world will see that we love you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Praise unto